here with Evansville Sports 360, and we're here talking to Otters pitcher Patrick McGuff. Patrick, it's a pleasure talking to you.
Thank you. Thanks for having me.
Let's talk a little bit about baseball. What is your earliest memory of baseball?
Earliest memory is when I was a kid, my grandfather always used to come along a lot of Reds tickets. He worked for GE in Cincinnati. So he used to get field passes for the Reds. My earliest memory, they used to have this little target thing, and they had little kids come out and throw and try and hit the target. And I was three, four, 5 years old and would go out in the Reds field and hit the target in Riverfront Stadium. It was a lot of fun.
So now, growing up, you were a Reds fan then?
Mm-hmm. Yeah, so, big Reds fan.
So does your favorite player happen to be a Cincinnati Red player?
Yeah, my favorite player, well, technically started with Seattle, but Griffey, yeah, Ken Griffey Jr.
Uh-huh.
So yeah, he was my favorite player growing up.
So now, going into your young career as a player, when did you first become a pitcher? When did you decide, you know, this is where God's got me at?
It was in high school. I was actually recruited as much or more as a hitter than I was as a pitcher. And so going into college, a lot of guys have told me, hey, man, you have a pretty good arm and you do pretty well off the mound. I think regardless of the smaller schools to hit, think you can pitch. And I never had any big school offers, so I ended up going to a junior college out of high school. Yeah, it was kind of towards the end of high school. I had a lot of good people telling me good information about me being able to pitch at the next level, being college.
What are some memories you have from pitching at Morehead State?
I mean, we won the conference my junior year, which that was, I mean, it couldn't have been any better. We played in a regional, we played Louisville in the regional, and there was 8,000 people there. And I got to start our conference final game that year too, so that was awesome. And then my senior year, I started and relieved, and oh, that was a lot of fun too. I enjoyed doing both.
Now, with the baseball draft going on right now, of course, this has to bring back some memories to you. You get drafted by the Twins, and it was the 38th round,
2036. Yeah.
What was it like that day as a player leading up to the draft? Did you have phone calls or did you have an inkling of who might select you?
Yeah, I had a couple teams that had contacted me and said, hey, we're looking into you. Not on the first 2 days, obviously, but the third day I got a couple texts in the morning from the Padres and the Twins, and my coach had told me that Boston also had called him about me. So I'd gotten a couple calls in the morning, and then from that on, 11 to 36 was nerve-wracking, and I never knew when it was going to happen. And I got a couple calls in like the mid-20s that said, hey, we think you're about to go. We're going to push for you to get you picked now. That was actually a Padres guy, and it ended up never happening. So I just said, okay, I'm done watching. I'm done listening for now. And, of course, my dad kept watching. And then I got a call in the 35th from the Twins guy who said, hey, we're about to take you. And I said, I'll believe it when I see it. And of course, they did end up taking me, which was great. Yeah, it was phenomenal. I was there with my family, which was awesome too.
Now, you pitched a couple of years in the system. They had you primarily in the bullpen. Had you always been a bullpen guy, or had you been a starter and then the Twins were converting you to the bullpen?
Yeah, I was a starter for my freshman year in college, I was a reliever, and my sophomore junior year, I was a starter. And then my senior year, I started the first half and relieved the second half. And that's when most scouts, I think, saw me. Mm-hmm. So they kind of pinned me as a reliever, which was fine. I enjoyed relieving a lot. It wasn't a hard transition at all either, which was a good thing.
Do you have a preference?
Not really. I see the good in both and the bad in both. And yeah, I mean, like, here I love starting. I've had a great time starting, but I love coming out of the pen too. It's nice to get that 7-8-9 inning adrenaline going. But I like both. It's hard to pick one.
Transitioning here to playing with Evansville, what do you think of the town, and what do you think of playing Bosse Field?
It's awesome. Some people that come in and play, they don't like how it's set up, but I think it's beautiful. It's unique, and I mean, the town's awesome. I mean, everything around here, I haven't picked out a bad thing yet. It kind of reminds me a lot of my hometown, so it works out well. We get the same kind of weather and stuff, too, so it's easy transition there.
Andy McCauley's a really good manager, been around for a long time. What do you as a player expect from your manager and the relationship you have with him?
Yeah, he's great. He's a lot like my college coach, and I love my college coach. He's very serious, wants to get to business, and but he's a very easy guy to talk to as well. So if you have any kind of problem, you can always go to him. But when you come to the field, you come to work, you come to get stuff done, and he has a high expectation of everybody, which I think is great. I mean, when he gets on you, it's because he knows that you can do better. So, yeah, I think Andy's awesome. I think the world of him, even though I've only been here for, a month now. So, yeah, I think it's great.
Do you have any social media platforms that fans and maybe scouts can follow you on?
Yeah, I'm on Twitter. I think the name's P_McGuff4. And then Instagram too, P_McGuff.
Awesome. Well, thank you so much for your time. And we really hope that if the Padres are listening out there, because you were checking in on him before, you ought to bring somebody out here and take a look. Because really, he's got the good makes of a great starter. Thank you for your time.
Thank you. Appreciate it.
Okay, God bless.